So today I'll be taking you in a tour on an online teacher's desk setup. This setup could be for your kids' online schooling too. Well, we'll give you an overview of the setup and talk about its significance and uses. Everything you need to know coming up. Hey, what's up guys, it's Mac here, and we do a lot of tech related videos like this one, so if this is your first time, consider subscribing. With that said, let's check out this teacher's desk setup. Okay, I won't go around the bush because I don't want you to be skipping the video and miss some important parts just because you wanted to know what PC are we running. So let's begin with this small form factor PC. I built this PC 2 years ago, and if you wanted to see the build video, just check out the card on your screen. And of course, by the time we're making this video, the PC parts of this build has already gone down. Well, except for the chassis, that is. And this is called the Inwin Chopin. I think this is around $125 or less, and still has the same price due to the high demand of the consumers. This build has a Ryzen 3 2200G in a Gigabyte B350 Mini ITX motherboard with 8GB of RAM in 2400MHz. Though Mini ITX build are really expensive if you'll buy the latest parts as of this time, but if you wanted to see the specification list of this build, just check out the description below. And the reason for going for an HTPC build is because we're trying to save some space on the desk. For our keyboard and mouse, I was supposed to put a TKL keyboard in the setup, but usually a teacher will always use a number pad, so we're going for a full setup here. I mean a full keyboard layout. So I decided to go with the MK215 wireless keyboard and mouse combo. It has a simple black design in full keyboard layout. And there's also a battery included in the box. Logitech claims that it's going to last for a year, but of course that is yet to be proven. Typing and clicking is smooth and nothing too fancy. As for the latency on both keyboard and mouse, it is good enough for desktop workload, and I didn't experience any problem trying this bundle. Both are connected in a 2.4GHz wireless USB and work best when the USB is close enough on your peripherals. I just went on this bundle to lessen the cables in our setup. Now for our monitor, this is an ancient one, but still works for simple workloads, and this is called Shimei. It's a 19-inch TN panel monitor, and our PC is connected to its DVI input. I actually use a direct converter cable from HDMI to DVI-D. I was trying to use a converter like this one, but for some reason it overheats and causes signal loss. It's either the unit is defective or it is a usual issue from this converter such as this. So I guess we'll be going for the direct converter like this one. And for our headset, I decided to go for the Red Dragon Ares because of its good quality audio and mic in a budget price. I actually made a full review of this headset in this channel, and if you wanted to hear the mic quality in this headset, just check out the card on the top right side of your screen. If you're in a budget and wanted a decent audio sound and mic quality, just grab yourself one of these. And if not being used, of course, we could hang it on this headset stand, which costs around $4. And for a webcam, this is what we call the Red Dragon Phobos GW600. It has a decent 720p video capture, a sturdy build, and awesome features. This also has a very loud built-in mic, though I won't recommend using it, but it is there if you needed it. We also reviewed this webcam in this channel, so you can check out the detailed video capture, mic test, and everything else on the card on your screen. Also, I need to mention that the capture of this webcam is a bit dark, so I decided to add a ring light like this one. I highly recommend getting one of these ring lights, especially if you're teaching online. Well, your student needs to see your face, that is. So this ring light costs around $10, and for the stand like this one, costs around $4. and it is connected by a USB plug that is around $1. Well, the prices may differ in your country, so check out the link in the description for more info. You might ask, why not just connect the ring light on the PC instead of using the USB adapter? Well, that's my initial plan, but the ring light, it's a lot of power and it is really disrupting the PC's performance. Just in case you don't know that this PC only has 150 watts power supply, so it's not going to cut it. Anyway, let's move on. And for the last gadget in our desk, this is what we call the XP Pen G640S. If you're an art teacher, this will be a nice option. Good for making large and small details on your artwork. This one could also be used in Zoom whiteboard, though there are a lot of cheaper options for that purpose only, but I guess this will suffice for a teacher's or student's artwork needs. Anyway, full review of this pen tablet is also available in this channel. And again, just check out the card on the top right side of your screen. So this is one of our teachers, the setup for online teaching, and I hope this video will give you an idea how to set up yours. By the way, make sure you check the recommended HTPC build, and if you decide to copy our setup here, all of the items in this video are also in the link in the description below. So that's it guys, if you found this video interesting and helpful, make sure you give us a thumbs up and share it. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one.